Hello and welcome to the ETFTL Season 22 mid-playoffs final sponsored by Saloon.tf. The teams are Peril Puppies and Professional Disney Fangirls. Looks like Professional Disney Fangirls is gonna be red and Peril Puppies is on the server yet. Yes, it's gonna be still a longer delay, though it's already 21:10. Our cameraman tonight is Vtoothed. And casting are Asash,
hello,
Cloudy,
hello,
Morph,
hey Lamau,
and myself. So does someone want to start with the Disney Fangirls roster?
Yeah, I'll take it away. We've got CJ on medic. We've got Corv on Demoman. Soldiers are going to be Seal and Unu. And on scouts, we've got Zatori and Kisakala. And for the Peril Puppies roster?
For the Peril Puppies, we got scouts are Mr. Linscock and D. Then the soldiers are Frix and Chief Dog. The demo is Mr. Will, and on medic, we have Homer.
Nice. What do you think about the two teams? How will they play against each other?
I think it's gonna be a really close game. They're both really strong, and they still have their weakness.
Okay, so map predictions, anyone in here? What do you think will be the score on this map?
I have to admit I don't have a lot of faith in professional Disney Fangirls on this. I've played in the team myself, and we tend to not be that good on Viaduct, but I haven't played for a while, so they might have significantly improved, so could go anyway.
Yeah. These teams actually have matched up before on Viaduct during the regular season, and Peril Puppies seemed to take that quite convincingly last time. So we'll see if the Disney fangirls have learned from their mistakes and are going to build up the heat tonight.
I also think Pups.tf is going to take the first map Viaduct. They're really like strong, especially D when he's main calling for them.
So you're gonna think it's like a 3-0, or will professional Tangles get like points off them?
Yeah, I think it's gonna be 3-1 for Peril Puppies.
So you think OD is gonna be the man to watch this game, or any particular players from either side?
I think in Peril Puppies there's gonna be D and Will is really good as well, but I see Chief Dog going huge as well.
Yeah. Well, we're on Viaduct, or Product RC8, as it's now more commonly called. Which is, the nature of the map has like led itself to lots of different strategies, including a lot of off-classing and things like that. Do you reckon we'll be seeing a lot of plays like Spy, Sniper, all sorts?
I know that the Disney Fangirls likes to run Sniper instead of Roma, so Seal is gonna off-class the Sniper. I've no clue about Peril Puppies. When I played with them, they didn't run a lot of Sniper.
So you can see more of the cookie-cutter approach from Peril Puppies, you think?
Yeah. I think their coordination is that good, they don't really require a Sniper.
Well, that's very interesting to hear. So no massive, huge, lucky plays coming from the Peril Puppies.
I think on Disney Fangirls you need to watch out for Corv the Demo Man and Isakala the Scout. Both amazing players with thick DM.
Yeah, both of them like have a lot of experience not only in Sixes but Highlander, and in Highlander you usually play Viaduct too. I think like, as you said before, on a professional Disney Fangirls you'll see a lot of Sniper plays because it's literally that easy to play Sniper on this map if you can afford to hit the shots and stuff like that. So let's hope to see some juicy back headshots.
Oh yes. I can already predict it. That's gonna run the Machina, new gimmick. Yeah.
Looking out for them big collateral blaze.
Maybe he's gonna go as the Stenion Dreamhack with it. Going with the collateral kill on the medic.
We've seen some Denia players. The map itself really does lend it to Sniper with all the crazy sightlines and all the like the king of the hill nature. Can really defend that point really hard, the Sniper, if he's hitting his shots.
Yeah. Cause like usually, I don't know, I just see that often in Sixes games, the few that I watch, that you just have your Sniper like on China or whatever it's called, and usually people can't really jump him or get to him before they actually get headshot or denied, because people...
Especially if you're passive with him, just protect him.
So I think that's what the fangirls are going to be doing this game. I think that's what their strategy will be based around.
If it doesn't work, I'm really sure that Seal is going to switch to Sniper. But for the beginning, I think there's going to be the Cookie Cutter lineup. Especially on mid.
Yeah. They got really desperate, they might also run a heavy. They've done that in the past.
So we could be seeing some crazy plays from Fango.
Yeah, the scout to heavy and soldier to sniper, it's not too unusual.
So it looks like there are 12 people on server, so I hope we're starting soon.
So you think we're going to be taking it to a third map today, do you think?
Oh, think I really hope so. Really hope so.
Yeah. Grand final.
What's Viaduct? Peril Puppies pick or Disney Fangirls pick?
Peril Puppies.
Yeah, that's Peril Puppies pick.
Okay.
Yeah. Makes sense based on their success during the season, especially against this team.
The maps are Viaduct from Peril Puppies, then there's...
Is it Gully?
Gully, yeah. Gully from Disney Fangirls, and Siders Badlands. And CJ just told me they went live, so in 90 seconds it's gonna start.
I think in about a minute and a half we'll get there. So yeah, general overall score, map scores,
3-1
by the team.
4-3 Peril Puppies.
In the whole series? Who's gonna take the final? Who's gonna get the skins?
I really can't predict that. It's gonna be so close.
Could be 6-3 either way, like, I can't really choose right now. While Viaduct might be, like, pretty one-sided, as you guys said. Like, I reckon Gully Wash will be much closer, and...
Yeah.
We'll see who shows up on the day.
It seems. I think Disney Fangirls is way better on 5CP than Cuff.
Which is a bit ironic, because most of them play Highlander, in my opinion.
Should be seeing some game action shortly.
I'm wondering if any of the demons actually run the loose cannon on this map, because the map is set up in that way where you can just get easy spam onto the enemy. So let's see if we can see some more gimmicks.
I don't think Korf is running it, but I'm not sure about Will.
Korf has been known to start using it. Oh, we are actually
going live.
Oh, nice.
So this is the grand finals of season.
Who's gonna take the first mid?
First mid. Korv sticking to the left.
Tiktok is going for aggressive bomb onto them behind them. They're really already on the point, while Disney Fangirls is really passive.
Yeah, losing numbers as well, Fangirl. Losing numbers, losing health. It's not looking too great for them at the moment.
Surely has to be a mid for Peril Puppies right now. CJ is retreating to spawn, trying to build his Uber in spawn probably because it's much safer. Let's see how the Peril Puppies are actually gonna set up on this mid.
Looks like Homa is gonna stand behind point. I don't think that's the best decision.
That's a risky play by the looks of it. It could be a sniper, it could be anything as far as he's aware.
Yeah, that's the final off classes from Disney Fangirls. They are just gonna try to exchange heroes.
Uno taking their rock. They're behind the rock as
well. Because
the
ball.
Oh, nice force. Nice force by CL.
Actually gets out alive, but they lose core of something that you don't want to lose during a new exchange, so on Seal as well.
Yeah, D gets Seal. Oh, there's the one we want. It's not getting out. Looking better for Peril Puppies right now. Disney Fangirls all bunched up on the left side. Peril Puppies doing the passive hold again.
Yeah, well, they can afford to do so because they have the point right now. They have to wait for them to push in.
Here comes another
bomb.
Deal with
the big bomb.
As you get it down now, he chokes and the Uno goes down as well. CJ too. Oh.
The space was made.
Oh, wow.
Just losing
play
players
by
so rapidly.
Killing the scout and the medic.
Still Will on point alone though. Everyone's behind him. Nails the pipe onto Kisser.
Yeah, already half of the time chewed off. It's not looking
Fangos for... did a good job there, they just couldn't maintain the point presence. Will was just left with total freedom.
They're going aggressive this time.
Here's
already
the sniper.
To... Ooh.
Sniper coming out of Seal.
Oh, D going for the flank behind CJ, but gets killed off.
Seal running the Hitman's Heatmaker at the moment. Interesting unlock choice.
Rick's failing his jump, just dying.
At least Disney Fangirl's got the point now.
Yeah, they're getting some time
looks
to
like
down
Kisser
there.
Is really aggressive. Oh, never mind, he's going back.
Yeah, this is quite a passive hold from the Fangirls. Probably just going to play around that sniper they've got. Try and keep him alive. Get those sightlines going. Get the early calls on where the Peril Pups Fangirl. Peril Pups Fangirl? Oh. Where's going to come from?
Big jumps, but they're so far back they just can't reach CJ.
Yeah. CJ taking a lot of damage.
Really good hold.
Oh, D actually on sniper, but gets taken down by Satori. And the way that Seal set up, like, you have to be really aggressive to actually get to the sniper, so it's
that's
one of those nice things about Viaduct, I guess. Although
that's how you do a good passive hold.
Yeah.
DJ are just on the cliff and your sniper really far back.
Still sitting on that window sill actually. Though.
Oh, they got forced. Will jumping in.
Double bumps
oh,
in and forces them himself.
Okay.
Yeah. Getting nothing with this Uber. Counterpop comes in.
Oh, Frick's behind them, jumping into them. Oh, and he gets CJ.
Oh,
nice play.
Chief Dog also got them on China.
They want to fight this. And this looks really good. They're getting sandwiched right now from Chief Dog and they're
scrambling.
Both scouts.
Some coordination.
One move. D has to fight both scouts right now, but Will comes in and helps him. Uno
taking
jumps in onto.
Ground.
Oh wow,
Ooh,
nice
Uno.
Rocket on Homer, but he eventually dies.
That was some decent time from the Fangirls, but not quite matching Peril Puppies. Still got some serious work to do in order to take this round.
60 seconds left and Homer has the Ubercharge advantage. Professional Disney Fangirls has to go huge now to save this round.
Still running Seal on that sniper there.
He has to go huge door now. If they're actually going to save this, since Seal is standing in the main right now, we'll take
Uno
him
bombs
to
forward.
Left side.
Swiftly gets out of there.
Ooh, nice headshot.
Ooh,
big
on
headshot
rock.
From Seal.
Oh, wow. Will gets dropped.
They lose a lot of players.
Got a soldier behind.
They should just get out and not pop.
So look, oh, CJ goes down to the bomb from Chief Dog.
Oh, this looks really bad. CJ gets a long spawn of 12 seconds and Peril Puppies has to be ready. Chief Dog spawning in 1 second. Uno is hiding in the corner on their cliff.
Already
but they all
players.
Go for main.
Yeah, this isn't looking too good for the Fangirls.
Yeah. Shot on the medic. Ouch, you dropped the medic! Jesus Christ! Oh my god.
What a shot from Seal.
Oh, two soldiers jumping in.
Ooh, nice bomb taking out too.
Great from Uno.
Actually, it has to be a block unless Will just caps it down without contest.
Oh, another nice shot by Seal.
This is looking a lot better for the Fangirls right now.
Gonna be an instant recap, and CJ has the Ubercharge advantage. That might just save them the round.
Could be seeing some double overtime potential here.
They will need to go for a dry push, otherwise CJ is gonna have to Uber before Homer.
Yeah.
And they're already walking in. Nothing going on. Wow, Kiss are getting picked on the right side.
Ooh.
They have so much ground right now.
Running
on
the heavy
to coming
cliff.
Out.
Whoa. That's what we were
Ooh,
discussing.
We're getting slightly aggressive.
Oh, big shot by Seal again.
This is looking really good.
Turning up right now. Oh, wow.
Uber comes out.
Seal just
in,
doesn't
but...
stop headshotting people.
Just popping him.
Oh, 15 seconds left. They might can go for an overtime, so they get the Uber still. This is gonna be really close. They need to move now. They need to get cap time, otherwise this is over. Chief Dog jumping in, Fricks as well. Going aggressive onto the point.
Oh, Can they take down the heavy dog?
Oh, they got the Uber. This. Oh my god, 3v5. They got the Uber. Four really weak. He's getting killed. Both scouts on point. Oh, nice shot.
Oh, that was so close.
I mean, we called it was going to be close, but I could not expect it to be that close.
Exactly.
Such a nice play by Parallel Puppies, just walking onto the point, getting that overtime, so they still get the Uber.
I'm coughing faster than Mr. Will. Will he take
Korf taking the first sickie, already weak.
Oh, he's getting jumped. Chief going down.
They're dropping players.
Down to Fricks and Link. Oh, a lot of people going down. Oh, this is disastrous.
Uno jumping in. Oh wow, gets destroyed by both of Parapuppy scouts.
There's the wipe.
Omo went down to 13 HP in that one, but managed first to survive.
First mid goes to Parapuppy again. Uno on spy.
Playing his own main clan.
Steel on sniper.
We have a sniper and a spy right now.
I wanna see some big play right now.
Gonna go on the spy cam.
See if he can get a cheeky snap.
See, what is Uno doing?
Sniper going down to a bomb from Chief Dog.
He's just spraying.
That's the spray.
Oh no. Blanking over the point.
Way behind them.
I don't think Homer is gonna
he
check.
He might get this.
Oh my god, Homer is like not doing something at all. Uno is so close to the stop.
Oh
no!
Oh,
you
get is he gonna get the force?
Is he gonna get the force?
No. Nope.
Oh, unlucky. That was so close.
Very ballsy play from Homer there. Not forcing to a spy.
Shield back on the normal sniper rifle now. No EU gimmicks. And the Uber gets exchanged. Theory dying again. No support on the left side for him. Korf and CJ all alone. This is not
CJ
good.
Will go down to the scout.
Might
messy.
Still take this though.
Yeah, somehow they just fast forward and get the point. Will Satori actually get the demo? No. Oh.
Yeah, I think this is gonna be an easy recap for Puppies now. Now they have the better spawns and just can walk forward while both of Disney Fangirl scouts are still dead. Uno hiding in connector with 144 HP. Jumping in.
Still getting the snipe onto Lin's dog.
Korf on point wants to contest this, and this seems like the right decision. Kissa going behind them. They're distracted right now. Need to look for both. DJ with 40% while Homa has already 80. If Disney Fangirls doesn't win this fight quick. Oh, Homa down.
Homa going down.
What's that, a cheeky sticky trap bar to teach us spam to sticky?
It's just some spams.
It's a double
very
bomb.
Messy right now, but looks like Disney Fangirls are gonna take it.
Porf and Kissa going down. They're retreating, just want to repush then. They don't want to risk it. He did 90% while Homer's still on zero. They're gonna retake this. No contest at all. Heal on sniper, they're gonna do the passive hold again. Which worked nice for them last time.
Any fancy sniper rifles?
Nah, I didn't.
Nope. They're jumping in, they want to do the suicide, but they're just told to
completely
get wrecked.
Completely denied, whoa.
Such a nice forward hold. This is just a perfect perfect passive hold. Puppies can just do nothing against it, but they're switching to an aggressive hold now. I don't know why, they have a sniper, they shouldn't do that.
Yeah, it's quite a risky play.
No one holding right side now, right now.
Parapub's still trying to pressure from main though.
This is really not a good forward hold.
Sword of Dragon.
Oh, Homer down! Wow, hits are going huge.
Nice flank,
bombs come in.
Pops into a force.
Getting denied again though.
This is a nice free pop for them. Homer's just gonna spawn and it's gonna be equal, so it doesn't matter. Time still going down for Disney Fangirls, 50 seconds left.
Still on this aggro hold.
It's a hiding above main. Oh, he's going for the medic again. Oh, but this time he won't get it. Chief Dog jumping in. They're retreating right now. They're all rushing them. Oh, nice shot by Seal killing the enemy demo.
Oh, but CJ goes down to Frigs. Just a lot of picks in favor of Peril Puppy, so this will be an easy take for them. And home the city.
See if Seal can still do something.
Ooh, the surf. Looks like he's safe.
Seal is peeking China. Missing a shot.
Yeah, looks like Homer's got a massive advantage here. Should be quite easy to defend anything coming from.
Homer is hiding behind this point. Right now. They know that they have a sniper, so he doesn't want to peek.
Bombs coming in from Munu. Getting denied very quickly with these.
This is really not looking good. CJ down again.
Yes. Turning into a bit of a disaster.
Something has to happen now, otherwise this seems like a round for Peril Puppies.
Is it quick fix time?
Quick fix.
Oh yeah, right, we're in sixes. Forgetting on this map.
I wouldn't mind seeing a crit
screen. Homer just standing behind point again. Need to go huge now. They at least need to force them right now.
Yeah.
This is not looking good at all. They're so far back. Nothing happening, no picks from the sniper. Finally the force coming in, but they're so far in, they're just gonna get chased out.
Yeah, losing players quickly.
Three down for professional Disney Bengals. Nice rocket by Chief Dog, cleaning up. This
round
is
two.
The second round goes to Peril Puppies. It makes a tie, 1-1.
Oh, it's 2-0.
Oh, yeah, they won the first round. Oh, already forgot.
I don't know.
Seal on the direct hit.
Some more gimmicks coming out from the
so
professional
many
Disney
from Seal.
Professional Disney gimmicks coming out.
Chief Duck doing a big jump again, going behind them, distracting. Frick's following up, wanting to kill Kissa. First pick goes to Disney Fangirls, Chief Duck down.
Fangirls being so passive behind that point, just giving up all the space.
Seal seems so much better for Disney Fangirls right now though. Only Linskog on point. He behind them, he's gonna go for the medic and get him.
Ooh.
Oh, and
one
the Ova. The 3k for D, amazing. Can he fucking do it though? He's connecting with Former again. They're gonna cap this.
It's the third minute in a row to the pups.
I don't know, it just feels like commitment issues for Disney Fangirls. Like they don't know when to go in or fully commit to a push, but the force comes out.
Force by Safari. If Disney Fangirls plays it right, oh, never mind, they can't do it now anymore. Seal dying, they can't re-push.
Yeah, Pups are gonna get a good setup here, most likely.
DJ has a slight advantage though, they're doing a passive ult. Deal on the sniper again.
Will trap
Unu going aggressive. Should be going aggressive right now. They already have so much free room, they can just walk onto them. Unu going aggressive again. Only the one that is focusing left side. They're not talking about right now what they're focusing. D behind them again.
This
Disney
Fangirls
set is
what they got the point at least.
I think Seal is gonna get focused on. Oh no, there's the 1v1 on their cliff.
He's actually behind them, distracting, pulling two people back, but he gets taken out.
Yeah, the Fangirls are just gonna try and settle back into this passive hole that has been so successful for them during these rounds, these close rounds.
So this is gonna be Equilibris again. Passive hold from Disney Fangirls. Sniper again. Where is he right now? Oh, he's on the right side. He's way too aggressive, his team is way too far back.
Yeah, push looks like it's about to come in from the pups.
They're all focusing point right now. Nice shot by Seal killing DDP. Uber exchange happening. Slight better Uber for Peril Puppies. Big bomb by Chief Dog doing a lot of damage.
Pups actually dropping players here.
Kids are going way too aggressive alone though. Kids are getting picked off for his overextension. So it looks like they're gonna repush from Cliff. Will already walking in.
Yeah, taking all the space.
They're scared of the sniper though. Homer doesn't want to drop down.
Yeah, sniper's getting bombed now. Team going in.
Oh, CJ actually comes down though.
Seal with the SMG pick though.
Oh, they just seem to give up all the space for free.
Yeah, they did the right thing. Feral Top just
they got
the
medic.
The point.
Homer's down.
Oh. Free be free right now, and Disney Fangirls gets a better spawn. They should just be repushing right now. Peril Puppies has still no medic. He just spawned. Kitsa picks off D. Kitsa is so aggressive in. He's
Will just
up.
Laying down the trap some point. Ooh, could get the down to CJ.
Oh my god.
Big trap by Will.
That one trap finally getting the cool. A good pick.
And they're repushing now. Chieftain gets picked off the sniper. Frick's low behind point. Still standing in the cheeky spot, close to China.
Yeah, Corp has to fall out here, there's no way you can stop this.
Yeah, Recap's
gonna
get this come
point.
In.
He's reconnecting with the combo on Cliff.
Will setting up that same sticky trap.
Yeah. Such a good sticky trap, though.
It's had some good success.
Yeah, Pup's
falling into the same
now.
Hole. Yeah, Pup's falling in the same hole with Homer behind point. Sort of healing everybody around him as they come.
They're not doing anything right now, they're just holding passive. And now they're
bombing
in.
Again.
Will Uno get it? Oh, really?
No headshot coming out.
Oh,
from
Homer gets 4, 6 HP. Wow.
Yeah, but at the cost of 3 people from professional Disney fangirls.
Steel is dying as well.
Yeah, he's just dancing.
Just jumping on the window.
Oh,
come on, guys.
Hey. Well,
I'm not
I guess
actually
that's
sure.
3-0 for Peril Puppies then.
Yeah.
Fuck these teams, like, honestly.
We told them and they didn't listen.
Yeah. We even told them just before that match went live. Please don't forget not to switch the map before the SCV can catch up.
So that's a 3-0
maybe,
to a.
Maybe
Peril
they're
Puppies
salty
the first
because
map.
They just lost.
What do you think the Peril Puppies mumble will be like right now, going into the second map?
I think they're pretty hyped, but they also probably know that Cuff is one of their strongest maps.
Yeah. What do you think will be going on in the professional Disney Fangirls mumble right now? I think, how are they going to recover from this loss, or are they just going to be thinking about the new map ahead?
I think they will think about the new map ahead, especially with CJ. He's always like, let's forget this.
Yeah, just... new map. New map, new game.
But they're obviously salty as they just switched the map. Don't want to see them lose.
Yeah.
Let's see how Golly Wish will go, though. I reckon that Disney Fangirls might be able to take this as long as they don't tilt after this loss.
Yeah, Golly Wish is one of is their strongest map ever. This is such a good map for them. It fits them perfectly. I think this is gonna be Disney Fangirls map with 4-2 for Disney Fangirls.
Let me actually take a cheeky look at the logs.
Ah, let's see who went huge. Corph with most damage, actually.
Yeah, like, but the lack of frags from Corvin.
I don't know. I think the score doesn't represent how the game actually was. I think it was way closer than 3-0.
Yeah, that first round especially, the double overtime.
Especially if you look at the team kills and damage. Even professional Disney Fangirls got more damage overall.
Yeah. Some crazy headshots coming out.
They just got 5 kills less. So I think this was way closer than it looked like.
I think it's the lack of air shots on their side.
Yeah, lack of sick air shots.
Yeah, I don't know.
Hope's
like
just DMing.
Watching that like match, like the damage was there obviously for the fangirls, but I feel like they didn't really have the coordination to back up their damage because like a lot of times you would see Kisa Kala just going in out of sync, dying, and then like as a result they had one man down already pushing in, and then that's where the rest died. So,
like, the defensive hold was really good, but if they lost their point and they need to go be aggressive, there was just the lack of communication, probably. They didn't probably call who to focus and not when they go in, and so there was a lot of, like, just getting free picks off them because some of them are overextending.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot more coordination come out of pubs.tf, especially, like, they're not even using many of the off classes that we're seeing the Disney fangirls use, like, just seeing they're doing the basic stuff well.
Yeah, exactly. Seal actually played more sniper than Roma.
Yeah.
Classic Seal.
Oh, wow. If your Seal got zero kills, a soldier.
Oh, wow, that must be harsh for him.
Yeah, Lidscock got a lot of frags alongside Mr. Will on that.
Yeah, that hold they had on just behind the point seemed to be working really well for them with that sticky trap on the point.
Also, Homer died twice as less as CJ. Homer just died 6 times, while CJ died 13 times. You can also see that Puppies probably had the better communication as they knew when to back out when something happened.
Yeah, clearly had a solid routine for that map, as it showed in the results.
Yeah, but I mean, like, even then, if CJ died like twice as much as Homer, Viaduct is like one of those maps where you can afford losing a medic because, like, it's so momentum based and it sometimes doesn't really matter if the medic dies. Obviously, like, it's always bad if he dies, but I mean, all of the rounds were kind of close, like, inching under 1 minute for both teams every time. Yeah. So.
If you look at the length of the rounds, there's a 6 minute 50 round, a 6 minute 22 round, and a 6 minute 8 round, so it was always really close.
But just like, it felt like the Peril Puppies flank like had Disney Fangirls' number, like they would always go behind them in really opportune times for them where no one was actually watching flank from the Disney Fangirls, and that's why they lost the points.
Yeah, we saw quite a lot more flank plays coming out of the pubs. Really did make the difference in the end.
Which I really find interesting though is if you look at Homer's like heal percentages, he gave the most heals to the scouts and demo. And the soldiers had the least heals of all. But if you look at CJ, he has like the more classic role of giving the pocket the most heals, then demo, then both scouts, and then Roma or sniper.
Really paid off for the puppies though with their flying plays to have more heals on their scouts and so and on their roamer.
Those scouts always cleaned up the damage from the combo. It's really good of them.
Yeah, so you think we'll be seeing more of this great coordination coming from the Peril Puppies on this map, or do you think this will be better suited towards the fangirls with their coordination in terms of that?
I think this time you can't really play so much with your scouts, so they will get less heals. And we will see more of a classic healing percentage again from Will, from Homer. But I think Disney Fangirls, like just because I played with them, they play this map so good. It's just amazing. I haven't played with pups, but I don't think they can be bad on it.
Yeah. Well, if they do the simple stuff right, like they did on Viaduct, then we could see a really solid performance from them.
He really likes to play with the combo, and this map is just so, like, you need to play when you go big doors as flank, you're just so far apart from the combo.
Going live?
Oh.
So we have map 2 of the E2FL Season 22 mid-grand final, casted by Vhooft Television.
Will going through choke while Korf goes through big doors. Are both taking their normal sides. Uno already
Seal
walking
is going
over
the
point.
G-Stock
jumping in, getting CJ. Such a nice aggression from Puppies. Wow, Seal getting a pick as well though.
Yeah.
This is 2v5 right now, and the middle goes to Peril Puppies. Such a nice like aggression. Hissa hiding. Oh, what?
Oh.
Wow!
Disney fangirls were just so clustered on that mid, they were all taking exactly the same damage as each other.
The mid is so good for Disney fangirls, they got so much aggression, but then the double soldier bomb from Peril Puppies with such a nice aggression and so good sync was like perfect.
Still, Homer went down during that mid, so we have equal Ubers for this last.
Got a really defensive lineup on the professional Disney fangirls though.
Wow. I don't know why they have a pyro right now, it's equal Uber, they don't really need one. I think the heavy's enough.
Maybe they didn't realize? Maybe Seal didn't call it?
Yeah.
They want to repush, like, this is a really bad lineup. Oh, looks like this is gonna be a river push. Let's see what they wanna do. Do they maybe think they have a slight advantage? No, doesn't look like it. They're gonna take it slow. See where there's an opening. Chief Dog jumping in, going on CJ. Oh, big shot by Chief Dog with the air shot. Wow,
that's not too good. This
such
is
a nice.
By
it's Chief Dog. Such a good position.
Yeah, they're popping
they're going
now.
In.
It's pretty much over.
Heavy gets immediately focused down. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a round.
Bricks and Linskog are in point. That's how you play Gallywash, you just focus the point. First one goes to puppies. Wow, such a nice play by Chief Dog. Both goes for Jorce again, while Will goes the normal choke rollout again.
See if
will they switch something up?
Yeah.
Seal and Chief Dog can counter each other. Seal is going to enemy drop down. Let's see if they called it. Chief Dog with such a nice aggression again. And get CJ again. Wow.
Seal with the bomb though. Getting missed.
Oh, nice pipe before from Linskog though. Only Homer up. He's already out. He's getting
far
chased.
Far better mode for the Disney fangirls.
I don't know if the chase is that good of an idea. As their scout is spawning, that is the. I don't think they're gonna get the mid.
Seal hiding?
Yeah.
That mid was just so much better coordinated from the Vanguards with the bombs. Massive damage coming out on mid.
Puppies was so passive, they could have probably blocked second, but now they're just on last. And now they need to repush with the Ubercharge advantage of last, which is way harder than just trying to hold second with the Uber. Oh, Hissa gets picked off. What are they doing? They shouldn't get picked off here. This is horrible. Now they probably don't even have to pop. They get second for free. Wow, this was horrible.
Yeah, didn't even have to pop for it. Absolute slaughter in that lobby area.
They still have 40% advantage, and now they can push middle with 6 people up while Kissa and Seal just spawn.
That's him.
Oh my god, Satori died as well. They should stop dying. What are they doing?
Yeah, just wasted all that pressure they built up. Yeah. Didn't even have to use on mid for. I think they're trying to get the force too hard. It's really not working out for them.
At least now it's equal lever. They're going for the single lever. And instantly going out again. I think they shouldn't have backed out instantly. They should have like tried to force them that they need to
giving
share.
Giving it a second now?
Yeah.
Oh wow, what are they doing? They should contest this. Puppies are two down.
This is looking really bad for the Disney fangirls. CJ having about a 20% advantage. I don't know if he's going to be able to build on that.
I don't think he doesn't realize that.
Yeah, not actually seeing any off classes though for this last hold.
They're in river again, Homer and Will. They're doing just a casual hold, trying to pick something. Oh, he gets picked.
Sacking this girl. Might see a sniper out of OD.
Yeah, possible. Maybe a spy.
Yeah, Gully last off is a lot of opportunity for off-classing.
CJ is such an experienced Highlander player, he will notice when there's a spy.
Can't drop those gimmicks.
And D with the sniper, like you called it.
It's a master game.
And
pushing out.
Oh wow.
Haven't actually seen the sniper yet.
Again. Deal might get picked off as well. No, he gets out. But it's 5-5 as well. Let's see, where's their sniper?
They're spotted the sniper though.
Shot comes out onto.
He just gets left alone, no one is protecting him. Oh, it's a stalemate, they're waiting for a good pick from D.
Sniper's going around the river.
Ooh,
he
doesn't get contested at all. Just getting the 150 body shot though. Kissa with the counter sniper now. Oh.
He's the 1v1.
Both missing
here comes
a shot.
The 1v1.
Hisa doesn't get a buff, so. Oh,
yeah,
nice
going
shot,
down
buddy. Oh, now it's. D won't get out there. He can't get out there.
Yeah, quite a mistake actually challenging that sniper with his full buff. Such a risk, especially with no buff.
Oh, DP came from water. 150 shot by Inno, he's so weak. And he gets out. Wow.
Not actually going in off that pick. Really, really.
The
way for
a better pick.
Really passive play from
there should be like some flanking right now. There's nothing going on in main or bottom lobby. They could easily get a pick there.
Spam coming out onto the sniper.
Gets on sniper again. He wants to try to counter snipe him again.
Yeah, round
hoping
two.
That this time it's better.
Should really try getting a buff from his medic.
Yeah, de-peeking from lower, lower. Oh, he might have CJ in his eye when he peeks.
CJ's holding in that corner, stay from the sniper sidelines.
Yeah, neither team wants to make a mistake here. Could cost very dearly.
E going to river again.
Surprised we're not seeing more aggression from
Kista
the dogs.
Kista can't counter snipe him, he's just standing there at the left side. He won't CD.
Yeah, I suppose the lack of aggression from pubs given that they're already around in hand. I'd have thought that they'd be a bit more keen to go for the picks. And then
getting
the pick from
down again. Maybe this time. No. They just don't want to push off this pick. They're waiting. Nice shot by a D.
Sitting in river. Massive damage on the seal on his spawn.
Please do something. I don't wanna wait 20 minutes.
Kisser on spy now.
Oh. DJ hiding behind the pillar. They should go aggressive on D, but they're not doing it. He just can't keep. Arby one
free.
Yeah, really doesn't want to lose this advantage that they built up now.
Sokolov's going all the way
finally.
Around.
OD going down.
D dying. Kisser with the spy play.
What's this Fangirl's wounds?
It's fine. Kisser can get one more pick. Just a scout or soldier. It's 2-4-6.
Unu being aggressive here.
Push.
In the lobby area. Getting some good damage off.
They saw Kisser going back to spawn. D with the heavy. Oh, this is gonna be Uber Exchange and heavy repush. It's gonna be finally a push happening.
Homesick so far back in river now.
Kisser still on spy? What the hell is he doing? Does he want to trick them? Oh. Okay, finally, switching off.
Nope, he's still spy.
Oh, he's going for a friend and medic disguise.
Heavy from OD now.
He wants to trick them. He wants to trick them, killing the medic.
Oh, CJ went out. Oh no, that's not CJ.
No, it's the dead ringer.
I got baited
Kisser.
By the DR.
Oh, it seems like Pops got baited too. They actually saw the medic die. Now the push is happening.
Amazing. Oh, amazing.
Well, next
play
level.
By Kisser. This is next level gameplay.
Coming from the heavy from River.
Oh, they have to focus his heavy right now. And heavy goes down.
Only Homer up.
This was
a total fail.
They actually won this off of that.
Will Homer get out though? It doesn't look like it. Homer is gonna die.
Oh,
will
maybe?
He?
If Kisser
Homer,
comes.
Yeah, he dies. He nice sticky by Korv. Krix is in, he should get out there. Oh,
really
catches
solid
the fight. And they're already pushing to middle. Nice aggression by Disney Fangirls right now. Oh, don't overextend Kisser, please.
He's always overextending.
Homa spawning. Still
like
a normal Uber.
Stand on second. Looks like they gonna take top river though.
80% advantage.
Yeah, it's looking really
let's see
tough
what they're doing
right now.
I think Chief Dog wants to go for a high bomb when they push for choke. Oh, let's see. Chief Dog is a buff choke. Will they check the spot?
Yeah,
they will. But Chief Dog is dropping down and
out.
Forcing them.
Ooh.
Oh, this is not good.
Early pop.
Yeah, and now they got distracted by Chief Dog as well, and their Uber is already over when they're on second.
I'm having a massive advantage now for last.
Uno peeking, top right, going for some spam for his damage lock.
Yeah.
Whoa, need to repush out again. Homa on 95%.
Fangirl's actually being really passive right now. On second still, not even considering taking lobby.
No, it's the right play. They should, like, puppies should push right now, which they also do. So standing far back, it's good.
CJ has it soon though, 10% left.
This took way too long to repush. They should have already pushed out when they were on 80%.
Oh, the high bomb.
Oh, nice.
This was close to a drop. Homo with 15 HP. Two down for Pearl Puppy's drop. Three down. This is not looking good.
They have to pass Disney forward now.
Disney Fangirl should rush last. Mr. Wolf spawning in 3 seconds. But they take on Uno getting in. Nice rocket by Uno on 2D.
Stacking for him.
Yeah. Nice one.
1-1 now. 1-1,
yeah.
20 minutes left.
What an exciting round.
Yeah, really, really close stuff.
Maybe we see a team going aggressive this time. Fourth going Big Doors again. Oh, they got Mr. Will going Big Doors as well. They're taking their side. This is really good aggression.
Seals flanking them, bombing in
on
the medic.
They're not doing the right play, they should have just mirrored them. Sheathed up with such a nice bomb.
Seals getting huge damage on them.
Core taken down though.
Jesus Christ. Almost getting out.
3-on-2.
Why do they give that up?
Scout's still underneath.
They should be fighting this right now and they're top? What the hell? This was such a misplay.
Yeah. What a mess from Pups. Real misread for that mid.
He was already in and Will and Homa just walked out to last.
They're gonna be pushing out though. They have to. Like, they have a full E, but they must be aware of this.
There's a sticky trap on the pillar.
They're
though.
Pushing through drop down. Korf spotted them. Big play by Seal again. Gets picked off this time. No, he doesn't.
They got Force in banana.
Yeah, Force coming out of Homa.
On the back half happening right now. Let's see if Professional and Lucy Fangirls can block the mid though. Which they not seem to do, so.
Yeah, you're just gonna stack it.
Yeah. Effortless back cap.
Maybe it was a lack of communication again that there's gonna be a backup happening. And they wanna push in with the Ubercharge advantage. CJ popping in, but it's only CJ and Uno. Where's the rest of the team?
So that sniper going uncontested in choke.
And actually,
now they are going
for
the backup.
Back
oh, wow, this was such a horrible play by Disney Fangles.
Headshot coming out from Seal though.
Nice shot by Seal. One arrow, the only 20 HP, nice arrow by CJ.
Once in a lifetime arrow.
Oh, and Kissa, Satori already in. They need to back out now.
Yeah,
Kissa, nice kill. Maybe he will get pick off Will as well. Kissa, such nice meat shots. Like watching a fragging machine.
Pups backing out to top river now. Really, really passive.
DJ with the 40% advantage. Sheathed up with the big bomb again. In. Oh, will he get... No, this time he won't get the easy bomb.
Seal might get the medic here. Nope.
Seal's still running that sniper. Not sure if he died for all this time.
Not the perfect time to run a sniper when you have Ubercharge advantage, but they need to do something off now. Oh, D with the pyro. They might get really denied.
Yeah, Pyro doing the work there, pushing him back into that lobby area.
He dying. If they can
medic down.
Delay
oh,
medic going down.
Oh wow.
Seal.
Should be a kill for Disney Fangirls will going down. Kisa under.
Only one up. Linskog with 45 HP. Nice pipe by Korf and it's 2-1.
2-1 boys.
Comeback is on for Disney Fangirls. They got their head in the game now. See if they can maintain that momentum.
15 minutes left.
We'll see if Pups can pull it back in this fourth round.
I think Puppies will run the normal mid again as the aggressive mid really didn't work out for them. Yeah, Will going choke again. Kissa going aggressive onto Will, instantly onto him. Misses his shots though and is dropped on 4 HP.
Eats a spam rocket from
Chief Dog. Chief Dog onto CJ again. Oh, and he gets him again. Wow.
Chief Dog really does have CJ's number at this point.
Oh, and Homa going down
to the
bomb.
Oh, nice pipes by Will.
Wipe from the fangirls.
Will picking off Uno and Satori with two nice pipes.
We might be able to block second though.
They really need to watch out for that Soda. He gets CJ every middle. Oh, what is Kissa doing? Kissa is hiding. He's going for the 1v1, and there's the Dada Scout. This was a really stupid play by Kissa.
Yeah, free pick for Pups TF there.
Equals Uber. nothing going on last. No off classes currently. Oh no, Seer switching to sniper and Sorry Heavy.
Yeah. Really, really defensive.
Calling that sentence, you just summoned off classes.
Didn't know you were a wizard.
Seer having trouble staying on the Roman spot. Well, let's see if he can actually do something on the sniper this time around.
Almost slightly building better, 10% advantage. But I don't think they will realize it. DJ will have a zero when they push in. Chief Talk going for a suicide maybe? Or maybe... Yeah, Chief Talk in. Going
Chief
on point.
All the way in.
Oh my god, Chief Talk.
Oh my god. Massive damage on the CJ.
That was so close. That was such a smart play, but just didn't work out at the end. Jumped onto point, and then he jumped from point onto CJ.
Might be seeing another off class from the pups to try and get this last point with equal Ubers.
Oh, Chief Talk just... Oh, what is Chief Talk doing? Just standing in
spot. Oh, he's holding the door open.
Yeah. Linskog coming back. I think it's gonna be Sniper. Yeah, it's a Sniper.
It is. See another stalemate here for another 8 minutes, potentially.
Seal on Sniper as well, so it's gonna be Sniper with Sniper again.
Yeah, no more Heavy from the Fangirls either, so... Far more clean run from the Fangirls for this last hold.
Let's see, Seal peeking peeking River, while... Oh, Linskog is River as well.
Could see a sniper fire here.
Trying to find an opening where Linskog can peek right now.
Both teams still so passive. No, not willing to make any mistakes.
Kissing Linskog very 11 HP. Nice rocket by Fricks onto Uno that just jumped Balcony. Seal picks
Seal.
Up Linskog.
Kisser on Spy?
I think they will do the same thing again. Linskog or D will go Heavy now.
Questionable play from Kisser on Spy right now.
Even showing himself in River.
Running DR?
Yeah. Oh, something is water. No one's checking water. Chief Talk walking on point.
There's the bomb.
Oh, he gets... Oh my god. They force CJ. Such a nice play by Chief Talk. They're so far away, they can't even reach Homo with that Uber. Oh, and the double scout through Shudders.
Yeah, Uber coming in.
They're focusing core.
Yeah,
core 14
really,
HP
really
on point. Linskog on point, they're focusing point.
CJ going for the block with
nice
Zatorin.
Shots by Kissa and Satori saving the fucking point. Linskog in one
language.
Let's keep this family friendly.
Oh, it's only
just CJ
up.
Now. Can he do it?
Uno respawned.
Oh,
oh,
CJ.
Nice.
So messy.
Standing so alone on point. Core going forward.
Will they go for the cap? They kinda have to at this point.
Yeah, it's a risky play though.
Oh, they are like a pick off here though. Kissa going in to get piped.
Such a miscommunication again. Kissa pushed while Korf and CJ went back to last.
Still 2-1 here though.
CJ with the Ubercharge advantage of 40%. They should be realizing that, and let's hope that they're pushing so it's not a stalemate again.
Could really consider
that
last
Frick jumping in from River. Oh, nice airpipe by Korf, destroying him completely.
Yeah. Great last hold from the Fangirls here. If not considered lucky. Kissa going for the Ambi play. Kissa getting really
aggro. What is Kissa doing?
The headshot log
this
bombing.
Is the biggest U gimmick ever. Fucking dead ring a spy.
He's almost mocking the pups here as they continue to hold last.
Yeah,
Seal running energy.
Stuck in lower at the moment. Pups see if that is. But
Seal on engineer
course.
This time.
Seal playing his main, ready to park the bus here it seems. Or just at least get some sort of setup on this last.
Looks like they want to push through Shudders. This is going to be Uber exchange 1v1. They're backing out again. Let's see from where they want to repush. Looks like they're repushing River.
They must be aware of the sentry.
Korf knows. Chief Talk jumping in, totally gets destroyed. They know that there's
sentry.
A sentry.
Sentry's weak, very, very weak. But it just splits the focus from the pups.
So
they have just that extra thing to deal with. Yeah, looking really good for the Fangirls right now. Pup's gonna have to find out some way to break this last hold.
Defighting the 1v1 against Kissa. He's top, really weak.
Pup's stuck with Victor right now, Mr. Will take.
He behind them. Let's see what D is gonna do. D gets spotted. But he gets out. Nice one. Oh,
nope.
No, never mind. Kissa is stuck. Will Kissa get out? Yes, he gets out. Littorio and Core 14 and Choke. They're really aggressive. No one is with them right now.
Yeah, it's quite a risky play from Fangirls. Team Littorio rejoining them though.
Oh, nice pop. Saving Korf and Satori. Unu getting dropped after Uber. Way better Uber by Pearl Puppies.
Homer goes down to Satori though.
Yeah, 4 down.
DJ and Kissa need to get out now. They might even get chased to last with this.
Yeah, D's on the chase right now.
Oh, wow. He
actually gets destroyed.
Kissa, oh, this is so close.
Oh.
That, this was the quad pistol.
8 HP on OD there.
Oh my god, Lin's Kogarian point getting cap time. Maybe they even want to push last instantly. No, they're just chilling, waiting for that Uber charge advantage.
Yeah, this will give Kissa a really, really good time to set up last entry though.
Kissa shouldn't have built while they were walking back. He should have been ready for people chasing them. I guess he just didn't expect that people would chase them up to last.
He's on entry now with a weird sentry spot, but it might not get spent out as easy as the other sentry.
Got an NG, a heavy, and a pyro here coming out from the professional Disney fangirls. Really major off-classing coming out for this last hold, but it has been giving them quite a lot of success.
Oh, Seal is taking weight. Oh, Seal! Big play by Seal, he's holding back Homer.
Oh my god,
no Uber! Wow, Seal's. Oh my god, Seal going huge and getting out! He just destroyed them.
This is
crazy. Chief jumping in. Nice rocket on Satori. Chief Dog is back on last. Dead. No, he won't get
the
cap though.
Get it.
This was big play of Seal.
Should be a free mid too for professional.
Oh, D overextending and dying. Only 3 up. 90% advantage for CJ.
But they are maybe looking to hold this. Pops that is. Let's see how they're gonna do it.
Will having his classy sticky trap. It's getting spotted though. They're already retreating to last without even forcing them. This is really bad for them right now. They're only 70%. If professional Disney Fangirls instantly pushes, they don't have Uber.
Got a really open sentry on the left spot door.
Kissa chasing Homer. They need to do something now. No picks until now. Kissa and Satori go down. Korf on point. Oh my god. Korf just doing this whole last alone. Wow.
Standing on the point.
3-1 for professional Disney Fangirls with 5 minutes left.
Yeah.
Pearl Puppies has to change the game plan, otherwise this looks like the map for professional Disney Fangirls.
Will CJ die this mid though?
Kissa going aggressive again on Mr. Will, doing the same thing again, getting destroyed by 2 scouts. Chief Talk jumping in, not killing CJ this time though, killing Seal, Satori.
CJ really passive this mid.
They should be chasing right now. Uno and CJ already walking to last.
This could be the first mid that CJ survived.
He wants
this
to chase. Oh no, he's going back.
Yeah, but because he was so passive, they basically gave them the point for free.
Oh, Chief Talk already jumping in, getting destroyed by Kisakala Meachart.
CJ was 40 health.
CJ just jumped off the high advantage and was close to die just because he jumped off there.
Yeah. Pubs are going to really have to look for something now with less than 5 minutes to go. I think professional Disney Fangirls just could be sitting here till the end.
They're already pushing in. Seal and Sniper. The Uber exchange is happening. Fricks and Homer getting out.
Yeah, the Uber doing absolutely nothing for Pubs.
This is looking good for professional Disney Fangirls right now. They have a heavy and no Ubers.
Yeah, these off-classes have been working really, really well from this game. The Pups have been, must have tried to push last so many times.
Both scouts in water, they want to go for it. Oh no, but they know about it. They're pushing in, they're sandwiching
the rain
just getting shredded by the heavy.
Oh wow, big heavy.
Satori going really big on the Thomas Lab there, yeah. Yeah, this last hole.
Yeah.
4 minutes left.
I think they're ready to just sit here till the end.
It's still possible.
Pups really do have to scrape something together to take this map though. They've been having so much trouble with this last push.
Have to make something happen.
Yeah. Professional Disney Fangirls doesn't even want to push anymore, they're just going for the turtle.
Yeah, equal Ubers again. Gonna have to look for some sort of pick advantage. Oh, they're just gonna go for it.
Wow, D getting dropped off the Uber. Bricks getting out.
Massive
river.
Denial.
Deal with the pyro play. Nice player by Zeal.
Just seems like forced from the pubs. They're like, they're trying so desperately to get something. Yeah. They're just killing all their time by trying.
They're just trying to get those.
Oh,
like,
Uno
last
behind, killing Homer and Linskog.
Yeah, they need to win three rounds. They need to win three rounds if they want to take this map, so. I think they're trying to rush everything. Whereas they have more time than they
Pups
think.
Has to block last if D wants to go for the back half.
That's
gonna happen. D going for the Ambi on last
the
versus the Pyro.
Oh, just getting slaughtered on second there.
What is D doing? Oh my god. Yeah, D is dead.
She's actually still a Pyro. And they push mid with a Pyro.
Oh, Seal's switching to Sniper now.
Homer trying so hard to build that Uber before they get there, but it doesn't look like it's gonna happen.
60% advantage. This looks pretty GG for this map. 2 minutes 20 seconds left and CJ has the Uber search advantage.
Hopefully the map doesn't change soon.
Yeah, I would appreciate that.
Guess we'll see in 40 seconds.
This still is possible if we get some massive momentum going, but it's looking really bad.
Frick's already taunting.
Huge taunt from
Frick. Just chilling. Yeah.
This could be his play of the game.
I think they already realized that it's over and they're just going for a
It is good that
now.
They're still playing though. It means they still have the hunger to win. It's really, really important.
Eric, such a change. Oh, Chief Dog. What did he do? Just died. Nice rockets by Uno. Going for some damage onto the enemy combo. Oh wow, Fricks totally gets destroyed by spam. Bull getting picked as well. This could be another round for professional Disney Fangirls. D as well. Wow, this is not looking good.
Yeah. Almost a minute left on the clock for the pups. I think they'll already be starting to think ahead of Badlands now. Seeing what they can do to recover to salvage the mistake.
Oh,
massive
shot
from
Seal.
Yeah. Really not looking too good.
Round in for
they should just be waiting for the Uber right now and play it safe. Hits are going for water. No one realizing it. Oh, now he gets it. Chief Dog checking water now. Linskog wants to sandwich Kissa and he totally gets destroyed. They popped in.
Will stuck on last, got his sticks.
Somebody should focus point.
Will still got his sticks on point. Is he gonna get the dead?
Oh,
gets the scout.
The Tori down. This is GG. 40 seconds left. Second round goes to professional Disney Fangirls. 4-1.
Even adding insult to the injury there.
Couldn't Peril Puppies get one more round, and my prediction would have been right.
So, with this round, with this map going to the professional Disney Fangirls, and with the first round going to the Peril Puppies, it's going to take it to a third round. How do you think that the Peril Puppies will be feeling in Mumble after having lost all that potentially lost all that confidence they gained from winning Viaduct? The control point is being
contested. You failed. Anyone? I think they felt really confident on the Cuff map, and now after seeing they lost 5 CP and now another 5 CP map comes, I think they need to like get more confidence this time, otherwise this map will also go to professional Disney Fangirls.
Yeah. They may have noticed that the potential for off-classing is a lot less on Badlands, so this may bode well for the pups. They may take advantage of that and use their cookie-cutter playstyle to their advantage.
Deal with 9 minutes of sniper, 5 kills, 1 death. But that pyro play, that was so sick from Seal.
That was really
huge.
Good.
Just saving the last. Button.
Massive damage coming out from Korv.
Yeah, Uno and Korv leading the damage and kill.
So, what do you think the pups did wrong on Gullywash? Why this 4-1? Disney Fangirls.
They never converted their pushes into points. They always fucked up their last pushes.
Yeah, they couldn't break that last hold from the Fangirls. Really solid. The off-classes. Didn't really switch anything up to try and counter it, to be honest, so it's just like flogging a dead horse in a way. I think given more time, they could have pulled something off. Like, they would have found a way to break it, but time was against them, and they just got, like, rolled back to last every time. But, again, new map. Pups might have fresh faces on for this map. Who knows what could happen.
You look at the heal percentages now, you see Homa giving Pocket and Demo more heals than both of Scouts. And as they're probably both of their Scouts are the strongest classes in the team, they're playing way worse than... They're playing worst on 5CP. Can't do so much with Scouts. Well, when you look at CJ with Uno and Korv, like, leading kills and damage with those heals, really nice.
So we are 1-1, and it has come down to the final map of this grand final in mid.
Just as we predicted.
What are the chances?
Also, Korf with a 3.8 KD. Really nice. Only 8 deaths.
Massive work coming out from Korf.
Yeah, Korf basically kept them in the game and was the key to their success.
Yeah, it really did turn up for that last map. So, Pup's gonna have to figure out some way in order to focus on their mistakes. They'll probably be realizing if they've got their head screwed on and they're still concentrating on the game and not raging, then I think they'll have a positive attitude coming to this, knowing that this is it.
So, who do you think are gonna be the key players for CP Badlands?
I'm not sure, to be honest. I think Seal could make some big plays. He's been having some success on his off-classes. Been getting some picks here and there.
I think on Puppies, it's going to be Chief Dog and D, or Linscock. And yeah. for the professional Disney Fangirls, it's going to be Kissa or Korf.
Yeah, Chief Dog just seems to have had CJ's number for this entire series.
Yeah.
Like, almost every mid CJ was going down to Chief Dog with his huge bombs. Especially with his plays on Gully last as well, getting the forces out.
Like, they either had to contest him on the bottom before he was jumping, or just focusing a scout on him jumping.
So yeah.
This would have been a ride.
He's been playing really, really smartly though, Chief Dog.
Yeah.
Props to him, he's been doing really, really well. Both teams definitely showing that they deserve to be here.
I think a key player will be Korf with his middles. I remember his middles on balance were really good, doing early damage onto them.
Yeah. Just waiting for these two teams to get ready here. Everybody's in the server. Spirits seem high.
Did I just TF high five on middle?
Got some high five action going on.
Oh, is that possible? High five should be banned.
Yeah, I've got some cheaters in this grand final. Unfortunately.
Yeah, default win.
Yeah, I'm just like looking how those teams did on Badlands, and looks like it's even turf for either team. I mean, they both won their Badlands sweep, but I think the Pups won theirs like 6-2, while professional Disney Fangirls won theirs 4-1, so this should be a really close match. I can't really tell who's gonna come on top of this. Really depends on how the mids go, because like Badlands is one of those maps where
you need to get the momentum.
Mm, exactly.
Yeah, this is it. Like, this is the one that we really can't put our finger on, because it was easier to tell who was going to win the other maps due to, like, the picks and how they'd done in their matches during the season. However, this map, both teams have had great success on this map in their season. I've never seen them play each other on it.
I think we will also see some sick sniper plays of Seal when they're holding second or pushing second. Those long sniper sidelines.
Yeah,
obviously had a huge success as sniper. Getting some sick picks.
Yeah, this map offers quite a lot of opportunities for sniper on second and last. However, on a mid especially, it does favour the default sort of setup from both teams.
Yeah.
So it could be a really big DM fight, or it could be how both teams play mid.
So the only many ways one I you can saw off-classing to balance mill was Flippy.
Yeah. It's the only one crazy enough. Yeah, this could be
This is a real test of both teams. CP Badlands, the staple of EU 6v6.
Yeah. And so far, this match, like, both medics never really switch off their mediguns, so maybe...
Yeah, I think we didn't see one crits once.
Yeah, maybe this time around we actually get to see crit screen. Who knows?
I think that's because both demo men are really not that confident with crits.
Oh, I think we're live.
Oh, we're going live. Last match of the grand final.
Brought to you by Saloon.tf and VHoofed TV.
Let's see, it's gonna be first and middle.
Corv, like Corv. Chief Dog doing a really fast bomb onto their train, but it's on 9 HP now, waiting for an arrow.
CJ really and nice. Thoma, really, really low here.
Nice aggression. Oh, nice bomb by Grix. Oh, this is really close. It's really, really free right now. E down, only Frix up.
They're also
one dead,
weak.
Two dead. Nice one by Frix.
Just Corvus is really, really low health with the Will and Frix.
Nice rocket by Frix. Corv only 24 HP.
Corv might want to retreat.
Yeah, he doesn't know. Frix doesn't know.
Corv got out. Nice mill by Frix, getting three picks. Saving the middle the last few seconds.
Yeah, really, really close mid. Uber's pretty much equal at this point.
Both Fangles. Still on, I would have liked to see the crits right now, but both are on normal Uber again.
Yeah. Potentially lack of confidence there coming from Corv.
Oh, they're already going in. They want to do a drive push. CJ's team shouldn't have been that far back.
CJ actually building an advantage here.
Seal's going to Haunter, going behind them.
Chief Dog really weak. He gets wow, nice one by Seal, getting the enemy medic.
There should be a re-push for Disney Fangirls right now.
Frix wants to go in from Haunter, but completely gets destroyed.
Oh.
18 HP.
Oh.
Gets big damage.
Nice
dodging
by
CJ.
Really,
CJ
with
really
balls
good damage.
Of steals. Oh, what the hell are they doing?
So
that was horrible.
Going down.
They're just
here.
Suiciding in. That was horrible.
Trying to get the force out, I think, but it's just not happening.
I think they're not calm at all anymore. They feel the pressure now. They
yeah,
feel
they
the
seem to be on tilt here. Mid all didn't tilt. Go. Mid going well too well for them, and that dry push may have been the mistake.
Well, what is Frix doing? He doesn't realize Kissa at all and just gets picked off.
Not paying attention at all.
Yeah, got an NG up on last now from OD.
Teal with the black box.
Yeah. Pup's trying to settle into last here. Mr. Will actually
pushing,
holding top left.
Pushing for main.
Mr. Will completely alone on the top left.
They have a sentry and a pyro. Oh, Satori
right,
just on
the
point.
Paying attention to Satori,
this
yeah,
was
so
really not good. The pyro did nothing, and when the skull was on point, the sentry also did nothing.
Really quick first round here from the Disney fangirls.
Yeah, only 3 minutes.
Just need to pull it together.
Let's see how the second mid goes. Maybe trying to push from Valley, pops.
Will fast in this time,
yeah.
Going Valley.
Will getting really quick to mid.
Nice two stickies on Corv. He's already really weak. Chief Dog jumping choke again. The first stick for the smell. Homa eating a pipe. Homa only 12 HP. This is
Corv
not looking
really
good
aggressive
for
on point.
Oh, nice bomb by Frix, getting the enemy medic. Nice two directs onto him.
Yeah, that's really the best. It's really the best they could have gotten from that mid. They dropped
Homa
a lot
surviving.
Of players
in. They already go to last. They don't even consider holding second.
Maybe a bit scared right now.
Oh, they're trying to hold it. They're going for it. Oh, Satori hiding. Going for the last couple of seconds on the point to cap it. Oh, Will
get
might
bomb
get picked
Will.
Off.
Will going really, really low into that lobby area. 4 HP.
E going for the recap. There are no EU gimmicks, aka backups happening.
Taking out Frix there.
Linskog is already really aggressive. Seal on sniper.
Yup, with the Machina, I could get some sick
choke more EU gimmicks.
Penetration shots.
Yeah, it looks like they're gonna come into choke here. I think Will's seen the sniper.
Yeah. Oh. Missed the shot. Now obviously he saw him. Thanks
yeah.
to Machina.
You get flooded now.
I don't think they want to pop here, but he gets forced. Homa gets forced. Corv is gonna get picked off. Getting melee with the sword.
Yeah, getting bashed.
Seal is watching choke right now. They might want to repush this. No, they're too scared of the spam.
Yeah,
they're
CJ
really
with a massive advantage.
For the Machina,
yeah, CJ with a massive advantage here. but without a demo this could be quite tough to hold with the Uber.
This is the time when you don't want a sniper. You have an Uber charge advantage and you want to push.
Fake call coming out of Homer.
They're pushing through house. There's a sticky trap. Oh, he saw Uno saw it. Oh no, this is not a good pop at all.
Mr. Will going down really,
Hits
really
are going huge.
Chief Dog is behind them, taking down Seal.
Pup's having to back out really, really.
They overextended way too hard.
Yeah.
Three picks.
They're kind of stuck on middle right now.
Actually, I think they don't even want them to let them cap middle, but they capped it eventually, and Satori forces them.
That's a really critical force actually, because it'll keep them both on fairly similar Uber.
Satori going for
Siege actually going down to OD. This will give Homer a really solid advantage going in.
Stubble getting picked off, because Satori's behind, probably not getting called. He just still dead for another second.
He's going in for Homer. Gets spotted by the scout though and gets taken down.
This is really risky, holding second now. Steel is so aggressive. Going back, they're pushing over resupply. He already on balcony, going aggressive onto Kissa. Nice shot by D. Another nice shot by D, getting two picks.
Massive flank from Pubst, really cleaning up the players that stayed on second. It's going to give him a really good advantage going into last.
It looked like it was a miscommunication again, because some people backed off, and obviously saw that they were pushing resupply, but two people were still on Spire fighting.
Yeah, that just shows how tense the match is for both teams.
Got a Pyro again, maybe you see some sick Uber denial.
Pyro and NG.
Really got the Uber now, but CJ only on 70%. But they want to spam the sentry.
Try not to split their focus.
Linkscorp sniper in the barrels, he's peeking main, and gets CJ!
With a body shot. That's CJ down. That'll be a massive opportunity. Yeah.
Oh, and Uno getting picked off as well. This is horrible right now. Linkscorp on barrels again.
Pups are in.
Focusing the sentries.
They're really weak after Uber though.
They're not getting anything with this, they're just standing in main doing nothing. This might be a hold from professional Disney Fangirls.
If they can hold this, just be the pinnacle of defense.
Oh, nice pipe by Will.
The pipe.
Will down, only... Wow.
They actually held it.
This was such a bad Uber. They Ubered in for main, and then they did nothing with it. They just stood main and spammed the sentry.
They took a lot of spam before they popped the Uber, so they were really weak after the Uber faded.
Rick's
just
hiding.
Got cleaned up.
Pup's having so much trouble pushing these lasts. Maybe something to take forward into next season, perhaps.
Doesn't look like they want to really push with the advantage. They still have an engineer.
Seal on the black box and conch right now. Running some crazy
Maybe the
unlocks.
22 minutes last hold.
Yeah, CJ with a massive advantage, actually.
More than happy
and
to
Puppies is going aggressive. If they push top lobby now, they could destroy them.
Sentry's up to level 3 now for the Nothing Disney Fangirls. Going for that sentry spam again.
But Kiss are repairing it like a master of Highlander.
The sentry in that spot really does split their focus. So they just have to take
The reflection kill.
Huge reflect.
Rick's just wanting to spam the sentry and then there's a pyro in his face and deflecting the rocket.
Everybody just hold up in lobby right now.
Frick's off passing to sniper.
Oh, we get a cheeky pick on main again.
CJ must be prepared for this.
Yeah, I don't think he'll make the same mistake twice, at least he'll try not to.
If Frick's peeks Barris and no one sees him again, he can get eventually CJ again. But this time, this time they're spamming it actually.
Yeah, they're well aware now.
They haven't spotted him yet though.
Oh,
yeah,
Rick's barrels. Rick's barrels. Oh, he gets.
No, they saw him.
Yeah, they're aware now, so. Pup's gonna have to do something to make this work. Otherwise, they'll be stuck here again. Just like Gullywash, it'll be a repeat of the same story. This last hold looking really, really unbreakable from Disney Fangirls.
they'd be quite happy sitting here for the rest of the game.
Yep, Sniper's not really paying off now that they know that he's here, there.
Yeah.
They're just standing really defensive.
Frix is just waiting for someone to overextend so he can kill him. But
yeah,
nothing
just
is going
up
on.
Their time. They know they don't have to, it's just burning up their time for the rest of the game, seeing as they're already a round ahead.
You want Frix to just go walk back to spawn, switch.
It really looks like the pups really don't know what to do here. Like, everybody's just stood still. Just exchanging occasional damage. I really don't know.
Guess he's just standing on a sentry casually. Could pick off Rick. He could pick off Kissa if he peeks up right.
That's that sentry though. It's really just denying everything.
Oh, Kissa really weak, getting picked off. Now they can spam
the
sentry.
What's missing?
Conch from Seal.
Conch from Seal.
As that sentry. Sentry's in such a good spot to deny that area down there, especially with the spawn.
Yeah, the sentry's gonna go down now though. Seal just holding its
so
punch.
So pups now have something to work with. They must go right now, they're really running out of time.
Yeah, Kisa spawning right now, they really missed the opportunity.
Still an engine.
Still an engine.
Yeah.
Would you do the same?
They finally popped in, it's a power play still. Nothing will happen from the Zero.
Big shot from Frix though, coming on to
Linskog. Bottom left. Oh, they're
pushing
top right.
They've seemed to have taken that area really well.
Everyone is weak from professional Disney Fangirls right now. He's suiciding for point. They're just suiciding for point over and over again.
Going down.
I don't really shouldn't.
Oh wow. Such a misplay by the scouts.
Last
push
so number.
Impatient.
Yeah. Well, they were sat there for so long not knowing what to do. When they got the advantage, they just took too long.
Korf just knew what they were doing. He was just spamming. Wow, Korf destroying Linskog.
They just take too long first. And
D on CJ.
Yeah.
Gets picked off.
Then when it is time to push, they get impatient.
Yeah. This really has been the problem, especially on Gullywash. It was more evident as it cost them rounds.
Seal actually running black box and shotgun, making up for his missing pocket.
Korf just spammed there. Puppies is staying really far back. They know that professional Disney Fangirls have an advantage. Stand on the point, you git. Nothing happening right now. They want to push through house, looks like it. Wow, this is a really good play if this is happening.
Pups just set on
they were. I think they were called. Yeah, Will already sticking house. The Tori walking through.
Walking for free.
Wow, they had pops way late, and Homa, they don't focus Homa at all. He's gonna get
Uber.
Uber,
yeah.
Wow, but Chief Dog and E dying. This was really bad for them because if they would have still be alive, they could have repushed.
Yeah. Seeing Kiss of Color on Sniper now. Could be an interesting play.
Any gimmicks?
More gimmicks from the fangirls.
Aww.
Kissa running the Razor back. Does that count as a gimmick?
Nice! Just stood there.
Cues the pop from
Pops. Coming in.
Should be a free middle for them. Just based off that
backup
by Seal. Let's see if he gets some sick air shots.
Pulling the whole team back.
Really nice play by Seal. Still holding them back. Oh
still
my god.
Is he gonna
They're
get this?
All back. Nice air shot by Seal killing off Frix.
So
wow,
close.
Such a nice play by Seal. They all have to retreat now to last. CJ has 100% advantage. D and Frix are just spawning in 5 seconds. They should run in right now.
Seal on Sniper now. Huge, huge play from Disney Fangirls taking that second. Massive advantage going into last.
Linskog on Pyro again.
This could be another round.
They're pushing in for top right. They realize they're picking up the Pyro. Uno on point, suiciding for it. Oh, they're dropping down. They just need to hold the high advantage now and then they can get it. Oh, now he's gonna die.
Yeah.
Korf is dead.
Still really, really good time on point. Offers opportunity for subtle back caps.
The team walked out while Korf was still in. Maybe he thought he's not gonna get out.
Yeah, potential miscommunication.
D fighting against Kissa, picking him off. Maybe also getting the sniper. No.
They could have gotten the cap maybe, professional Disney Fangirls, if they didn't have a sniper.
Yeah. I think Sniper was not the right choice there. They should have just stick to Soldier and push last. As they had like 60% advantage. Like this is gonna be a last hold again. Seal and Sniper with
another
the Machina.
Fake call coming out of Homer. Trying to fool the Disney fangirls into not wanting to push. Loose cannon coming out of Mr. Will. This could be some interesting double dunk plays.
Yeah, loose cannon really strong on last.
Just spam into that choke point. It's fairly easy
oh,
double
let's
dunks.
See a seal.
Grimmick
oh,
low.
Pushing close
in.
One.
Why are they just pushing? Oh
easy,
my god.
Get the point. Oh my god. Something's about to happen.
Massive error from Pups.TF
wow.
here.
This guy just ran in main and can't, like.
This was horrible. This shouldn't have happened.
Yeah. Their demo took a lot of damage, just walked back to resupply. And while that was happening, they just ran in and took the point.
Or first to mid again, getting the first sticky.
Big bombs from both Solis here.
Pissa getting
huge bombs.
CJ reconnecting.
Chief Dog jumping in.
But he gets taken down by Chief Dog.
Oh my god, Chief Dog. Oh,
kid.
Oh, Satori getting the medic. They want to find this. Satori getting the demo, maybe. Oh my god. Uno! 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 3k! Saving the fucking middle.
Oh my god.
Language.
That was almost a really, really good middle from Pups.TF there, but Unu flying in and getting that 3k.
I think he wants to contest the middle, he doesn't want Fricks to let it cap.
Can he get it?
Oh,
he gets
he
it.
Actually blocks
this
it.
Was really bad by Fricks, he just spammed house, and when Kissa went was finally on middle, he didn't have anything reloaded.
Swapping for the Aussie, Seal.
Easy mid cap for professional fangirls right now. Neither are even though because both medic died at the same time.
If they decide to cap mid, oh there we go.
Kisakala deep actually gets spotted by his team down so he doesn't die.
They're holding trash. They want to contest fire. Corf is just alone in trash.
Yeah,
Unu could have picked him up.
Yeah, CJ walking in really, really slowly.
Equal Uber, they're both close to Uber. Looks like they want to go back. Fricks is behind them. Oh wow,
instantly shut down, yeah.
See what they want to do. Oh, nice spam by them both.
Yeah,
oh wow.
Homer pops.
Nice rocket by Uno, picking off Chief Dog before the Uber happened.
Yeah, Homer kind of forced a multi, actually drops his scout that he was first Ubering and retreats the trash right now.
Massive misplay
gets the medic,
Uno is just going huge this map.
What a disaster for the puppies.
Four
only
down,
both soldiers up. Zero already on point.
And that's it.
Nothing they can do.
Another round of the bangles.
Puppy need to change something. They need to get at least one round. They need to start to get momentum. 12 minutes left.
Pups are looking really, really shaken right now. They need to shake off this tilt that they've been having for the for these past couple rounds. They were looking really strong at the start of the map.
Looks like they want to go shit house. Oh no, they don't.
You just walk up slope.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, Pops is way
faster. They should have been both soldiers doing a sync jump. Oh, nice air shot by Uno.
Oh.
Holy shit.
Uno's stepping on it right now.
Yeah, massive mid from
Will
Disney
only 30 HP. He's gonna get picked off by Kissa that is behind him. Or Seal.
Wipe.
Wow.
That's a wipe from the
Pups. This doesn't look good for Pups at all. It looks like they lost their whole confidence. Nothing is going on anymore.
Yeah, like Disney Fangirls is just pushing, like pressing that W button and pushing them out every minute.
Already sticking up lobby is Corv. OD on sniper for this last hole with Lynn's Cargon Pyro.
100% while Homa is only on 30.
It's looking
they can
really,
take
really
their
bad.
Time for that push.
Mr. Will on that loose cannon.
Looks like
again,
they
want to
go for main.
Happen.
They pop for main. Uno jumping
straight
point.
For the point.
Oh, wow. Oh my god, this is looking good. They need to drop down. Wow.
There it is.
Perfect play.
Yes. The last, possibly the last event from this mid finals.
was a perfect push. Steel just jumping point, distracting them all. Got some cap time, so they had to drop down, and then they just got killed off by Korv.
Yeah, massive damage coming out from Korv on that last push. This could be our final mid, as Asajj said.
Korv is going balcony. Will as well. Oh wow, Frick's getting destroyed, but nice aggression.
Yeah, huge aggression.
Oh wow, Seal destroying Homer and Linsko.
Right now.
Only one, Will up.
Four. Oh my god. Will actually getting out though. Will not get chased.
What is Seal doing?
Seal might chase him?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh, he's actually. Oh, he felt his jump down.
Oh, he got the medkit.
Seal is so aggressive.
Nah, he's not gonna go for it.
Yeah. Looks like Seal is hiding. Hiding in trash.
Yeah, just trying to maintain the last hold, OD on NG. Trying to set something up to hold this.
Looks like Puppy Swan to go for second defense though, so it doesn't matter. Frick's in trash, completely out of... But what was he doing there?
Tilting.
Okay, DS Engineer and Linskog on Pyro, CJ with 100%. This could be the final last push.
Pubs really need to make
Looks
something
like they
happen
want to go for main again. They popped in, the sentry completely destroying them. But the sentry getting picked off now. They're just walking on point again.
Oh!
Oh my god.
Flooding point.
This is so close.
Stickies.
Only D up. 2v1.
Oh
my god. GG.
GG.
The X kill, the last kill of the mid playoff final.
Season 22 going to the professional Disney fan kills. Great Badlands play from them.
Wow, I really didn't expect that they will get a win difference on the last map.
Yeah. It was really close up until this point, to be honest. Even the start of this map was looking close, but Pups.tf seemed to fall apart at the seams as soon as rounds started building up from the fangirls.
Yeah, I mean, like, every mid, they just got pushed out by fangirls. Like, they were so passive and kept losing people because they went in at unopportune times. And that's basically how they lost every middle, like, starting from the second point they got.
Try and get some interviews here. Seeing some fangirls players joining the mumble. Might. Don't know if we'll see any pups.tf players. Hopefully we do.
Just actually looking at the box right now, Korv getting 18 kills and only dying 3 times.
Hey, Lamau! Hey!
Hello.
Hello.
Congratulations on winning Season 22 mid.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Played very well. So, how did you feel as the first round, after the first map struck, and it was 3-0 after that map? What were what was the environment like in Mumble?
We just considered that it was their map pick, and that we'll go to our maps now, and we'll run around them.
Yeah, I mean, we banned it, like, in the quarterfinals and the semifinals, but we felt it was a better idea to ban Snake, and I guess they picked up on that. And we were like, when they picked it, we were like, oh no, that's good, we can play on Viaduct or Product, whatever. But Unu throughout the is like he doesn't know how to play Product, so it was like, it's fine. Like, as Kisa kept saying, we're better at 5 CP, so you know, we didn't let our heads drop, we just got on with it.
Yeah, it really did show as you went on into Gully, and your last holds were just incredible. Pups.tf could not break that last. It was unreal. What's the secret? Is it the talent and the Highlander players?
The secret is don't die.
It's the legendary Furbo from Furbo Pandas taught us that if you want to win, you gotta play like a faggot. Yeah. That's what we did.
Language.
At the end
that's
of the day,
what he
like,
said. Quote unquote.
You've got Seal, who's really good at sniping. So when you've got that in your team, like,
what?
It's so we just kind of played the right classes, I think, and just thought there's no pressure for us to push out. Like the only point where it got awkward was when they were 1-0 up on Gully, and we couldn't have sat there for 30 minutes, otherwise they would have won. But we knew we just had to wait for the right moment and not get too eager, which, you know, eventually it came and we managed to push forward.
Yeah. So we have Homer and Mr. Linskog here from the Pups team.
Linskog.
Commiserations to you guys for that last map and Gully Wash.
Hello, people.
I can't
good
hear
games.
What you're saying, dude.
GG. How did you feel after the first map that you won so confident? Rio.
Pretty good. We thought we had good coordination, we had good calls on the first map. I don't know, was pretty gone as planned. The flank was we could have gone to flank very often without being pushed back, so that was easy. But yeah, well, in the end, they just played better on the 5CP maps. Really well deserved win, boys. Well played.
Yeah, so what do you think went wrong on Gullywash, Dan?
Yeah, was there a moment where it all sort of crumbled down? Was there a lack of comms or how?
Fucking sentries, man. Fucking sentries. I hate them. Who was that bitch who always built a sentry? I hate you. I hate you.
No, it was Kizakala. Yeah, it was Kizakala.
But dude, I fucking raped you on Gullywash, man. I would two-shot you every now and then.
Well, yeah. There was some push after when we had one point up and just pushed us into lobby or whatever there was. Just broke everything down, basically.
So would you say after Gullywash you lost your whole confidence on Badlands as well?
Not the confidence, really. Just the coordination.
Yeah, your first round on Badlands seemed really solid, but it seemed to deteriorate over time.
Especially
was that noticeable?
Especially after professional Disney Fangirls got their two mids, your crumble just on every middle that followed up.
I don't know. We were playing really one-dimensional. We just went more aggressive and more aggressive, but I think they totally used that and just baited us onto the point. Kizakala and the scout was just flanking from everywhere when we went over point. There's a scout Uno, I think it was.
Satori.
Yeah, Satori.
Right. Anyway. Well, if anyone's got any more questions, I think that's about time for shout-outs, maybe?
I just want to, before shout-outs,
go ahead,
I just want to say, I hope this dispels the myth that Raptor carried us. but also, with all due respect, with all due respect, I think that the teams that got to the semi-finals were all really, really good. When we played against Gink's team, it was a really close match, and I watched the Pups versus iOS game, and that was insanely close. And this game went sort of back and forth. So I think, we can say the top four teams and even the top two teams deserve to be, and it was a really, really good season. It was really fun.
Yeah,
so
it was
fun. Congrats to everyone. It was really, really nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, both of you guys played really well in that final, I noticed.
How surprised were you on the last push where we got a sniper pick and the soldier pick and then just your sentry destroyed everyone? How surprised were you? Just asking.
I don't even remember which one that was.
too many.
As the person who got those two frags, I'm pretty mad.
Which map?
Was on Bally Gully.
I was on Bala.
Oh, that one's.
So Frix got the two picks.
You killed me, I dropped full conch. I had a full conch, walk out the door and get sniped. I'm like... oh. I spent 5 minutes spamming a door with his conch. And then to get headshot.
Yeah, you just popped through main and then you did nothing. You just spammed the sentry from main.
Yeah, that was
not the plan.
We were both soldiers were weak and then Will jumped into it as well and Homer just had to use...
So what was this?
Yeah, there was we were spamming sentry, but we couldn't spam it because it was really weird angle.
Yeah.
And then
that was, Badlands, fuck that.
That was
honestly.
Actually where I tilted.
Even as a demo man, I fucking hate sentries, honestly.
It's gay, I know.
After that, we had nothing.
Well, okay. That's what I made demo.
So let's move to shoutouts.
Yeah, yeah, I want to actually say something because this is actually Homer's last season. He's gonna turn to better things, real life and his girlfriend.
Better.
So I just wanna say,
good choice,
like,
man. Good choice.
I just wanna say, Homer, thanks for playing, man. I wish you all the luck in the future. So, I hope to see you come back to competitive at some point, maybe.
See you next
season. Good luck, Homer.
Gosh,
you're allowed to roster ride.
You make us look like assholes here.
So let's move to shoutouts. CJ, do you have any?
Shout outs to my team, everyone. It's been a really fun season. I've enjoyed it, and like I said, it's been really close, so these last few games have been really enjoyable. Shout out to whitelist.tf, who sponsored my Highlander team, so shout out to them, we'll be playing again soon. And shout out to Pups, thanks for a great game, guys. And to you guys for casting, of course.
Yay.
Chief Doc?
Shout out to Fox. Who else? Gesus, I guess. And not a shout out to OD for taking a 1v1 heavy fist fight, even though I wanted a heavy fist fight.
Yes, somebody, Linskog said I should do it, so I just did it.
Yes, wanted to get it over with, please.
Yeah.
So, D, any shoutouts?
Yeah, shout out to Olga, News, Raziel, basically the whole MLB crew. Blub, Feeling, all the German people I always play with, I love you all. So, oh yeah, and Ash and Arden, who were like super carries of the season, or like super subs.
Oma?
Yeah, never forget the origin, sorry.
Just to my team, it was a really awesome season. I'm sad it's over now, but it was cool.
Shout out to Hildreth, WTF, Julius Bright. Shout out to Dirk Fusio. Shout out to my mom and Una's mom.
Mr. Linskog.
Shout out to my man Sorgen, if you're watching this. Yes, that's a Swedish word, I'm sorry.
We're Swedish, we know.
And let's see, shout out to Orton, of course. Shout out to Snow. Shout out to Marvin, if you're fucking watching this, you better. Bitch.
Oh yeah, and Verse, but Verse, fuck.
Yeah, shout out to Verse, if you're watching this. Shout out to Jesus. Or, I don't know. I don't even believe in Jesus. Shout out to my mom.
Uno.
Yes, shout out to everyone around the world. I don't know.
Ooh, everyone. Yes. That's a lot.
Especially Morph.
Shout out, Sled.
Yeah, thanks for casting, guys.
Deal.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah, thanks for casting.
I don't know why shout out to Toast. Toast is the best and I love him. Lots of love to Toast.
Okay. Also, Will? Toast is really good.
Shout out to his team, just for being like the second ever team I've main classed ever. And we're going to have to go fucking top mid, which is amazing. And I didn't expect that at all, but yeah, really did well. Carried Sash. Me as well.
Shout out to my other team, strong opinions. Shout out to the MVM Benta boys, who I always play MVM with. And shout out especially to V2 for making this happen, and my fellow casters. And of course the two teams here, giving us a great game. Shout out to you guys too.
Shout out back. Sup dude.
Cloudy?
Yeah, just shout out to all the teams that played. Thanks for giving us a great game to watch and cast. It's really good.
Morph.
I don't like shouting. It's obnoxious.
Yeah, that's awkward.
But you're German.
Nein!
Panzerkampfwagen!
See you. Oh, see you next season, guys.
Yeah, see you next season.
Shout out to Simon and Admirable from my side, and I guess this is it. This was the ETF 12 Season 22 mid-playoffs final, which went to 3 maps, and at the end, Professional Disney Fangirls took it home.